I'm going to show you guys to learn how to make some applesauce. The first thing you want to do is, once you wash your apples, you want to stick this thing in there and just cut the stem out and peel the apple. I'm making a breakfast for my kids and wife this morning, so I thought I'd show you guys this little quick applesauce recipe. Cinnamon, you need sugar and a little bit of water. Okay. Okay, so now what you're gonna do is you cut them into tiny little pieces here. Potatoes, kind of, you know. And then once you cut them all up in pieces and stuff like that, you put them in a little pan, in a pot, and stick all the apple there. Put a little water in there. Not like this to keep them all, you know, moist. You don't want to put water, put some out. Cinnamon, 1 tablespoon of sugar. I like to put a little more extra mine, and then put them in the water and in the fire. And put a lid on it. I was gonna do it on this one, but I didn't end up doing it on that one. I don't know what. Anyways, just let them sit there for a while. Once they start boiling, you're gonna use the. Okay, so now that you see boiling, as you can see, it's boiling, you need to take more water out. I might have put a lot of water in there, but just kind of smash it with a potato smasher. See, it's starting to look like mashed potatoes. I mean, mashed potatoes. So there it is, guys. Okay, so here we go. We made it. We got some cinnamon rolls and some scrambled eggs, and there's the applesauce right there that I showed you guys how to make. So I got 5 kids, so actually 4. And actually 3, because my wife doesn't count as a kid. But so there you go, guys. Enjoy the recipe this morning, and thanks very much. Cinnamon rolls. You can always get those already made in a box, and you just take them out, put them in the oven for 10-15 minutes. The eggs. I'm sure everyone knows how to make eggs. So thanks a lot. Subscribe and like. Big thumbs up. Remember, you'll never know what I'm gonna come up with next. So subscribe, and you'll be surprised. Bye. Okay, good morning, everybody. I'm having breakfast this morning. I'm gonna share with you guys what I'm having right now this morning. I'm having a really healthy breakfast, and I really liked it the way I made. I got some old brands here. It's the little, you guys can see. It's all fiber. For those who need fiber, it's old brand, okay? It's very healthy, and it makes you feel very light. You don't need that much, and then put some frambuesas on there, and banana, and some milk. So I forgot to mention honey. You gotta put the honey in the cereal, and the banana, of course. And I'll cut it up right now and mix it all up, and then see what it tastes like. Okay, so now we're gonna put some honey. Yummy. I like a lot of honey on mine, so. And then I put some milk on it. I put the raspberries and the banana. And then pour some milk on it. And then mix it up a little bit. Oh, look at that. That is, looks like some healthy fiber, vitamin. It got, I mean, the raspberries are very, very healthy for you. Okay, now we're gonna taste it. Get a little piece of banana, raspberry. Oh, that one doesn't wanna go.
Oh. That is some healthy breakfast. Okay. My girls are laughing at me big time over there. That's just mean. They say, why would I put a video like this on YouTube? But I decided to share this morning, so God bless you guys. Have a good day. Okay, buenos dias. Good morning, everybody. This video is going to be English and Spanish. I'm going to show you guys how to make hash browns. Les voy a enseñar cómo hacer hash browns. Si no saben lo que es hash browns, les voy a decir ahorita. Primero vamos a empezar con una papa. Y los ingredientes que ocupas es una papa, aceite y mantequilla y un sartén y agua. Lo primero que haces es pelar la papa. Ya, primero vamos a pelar la papa. Ya que esté toda pelada, vamos a usar we're gonna use the, once it's all peeled, we're gonna use the, this thing right here, forgot what they're called. O sea, voy a usar este ya que se pela toda. Ok, now that it's peeled, ahora que ya está pelada, vamos a usar raspa quesos. We're gonna use the shredder here, and we're gonna shred it into a bowl of water. Le vamos a echar en un contenedor de agua limpia de garrafón. We're gonna put clean water in a bowl, and we're gonna shred it here. Para que no se ponga moldy, se ponga color feo, y so it doesn't change color, it gets ugly coloring, and you know, you want it still looking nice. Quieres que se mire bien, entonces vas a rasparlo todo aquí. We're gonna shred it all into the water, all the potato. Aquí en el agua. Okay, ahora nada, we put all our potato in here. Ahora que está toda la papa aquí, ya va a ser el hash browns. Y vamos a lavarlo bien para quitarle todo el almidón, el starch. We're gonna wash it down, get all the starch out. If you see, the water is kind of like white a little bit. Not white, but you know, it's got the starch. Tiene todo el almidón. Vamos a lavarlo bien. Y después lo vamos a secar. Then we're going to dry it with a towel and some napkins that I have set up here. Okay. Okay. Now ya que lo colemos, now that we strain the potatoes really good, sacarle lo más agua que se pueda. We're going to take the most water out we can. We're going to dry them the most we can. And for this, I have a little, para esto tengo una toalla con toallitas with little napkins and a towel. I'm just going to put it in there. You know, kind of just smear it out in there. Para que se seque bien, so it'll dry really good. You don't want to keep any water in there. No quieres que tenga mucha agua por cuando la fría, so when you fry it. So you want to smear it out a little bit like this. Quieres ponerla así. Y que se seque poquito. We're going to spin it. And dry it. Vamos a darle vuelta así. Y presionarlo. Para que se seque. Y ya que esté todo seco, ahorita lo vamos a ir a enfriar en el sartén con lumbre mediana. We're gonna, once it's all dry out, we're gonna go fry it in the pan with medium heat. Okay. Okay. Ahora, now that we they're dry out, we're gonna lo vamos a echar un platito. Try to dry them the most you can. Trata de secarla lo más que se pueda, sacarle lo más agua que se pueda. Si lo puedes meter en otra toallita y hacerlo todo otra vez. If you can put in a napkin and squish all the water out, that'll work just fine. Okay. So I got most of the water out. You want to play with it a little bit. Tienes que jugar un poquito con ella para que se le saca toda la humedad. Okay. And okay. So here we go, ya está medio seca. Si quieres secarla más, you're gonna dry it more with more towels, that's better, that's fine. But so far, so good. Okay, now let's just go to the pan and fry it. Vamos a, ya que le sacaste todo el agua bien, vamos a friarla, te les enseño cómo vamos a hacerle. Okay, here we go. Vamos a prender el, we're gonna turn the stove on. El mediano. We're gonna put it on medium. Add some butter on there. Un poquito de mantequilla. y aceite de olivo. En este caso, I'm using olive oil. No tengan miedo a echarle el aceite de olivo porque es lo que va a hacer que se doren. Approximately about that much, the olive oil. Let it warm up a little bit. Once it warms up, you can throw the hash browns. Ya que se caliente y se ponga cerrita todo, le puedes echar el hash brown, la papa, pues. Y we're gonna make little heart shapes. Vamos a hacer como diseños de corazón. So stay tuned, quédense atentos. Okay, now, ya que está caliente, now the oil is warm and the butter is melted, vamos a echarle, ponerle como corazoncito, y le vamos a echar ahí la papa, para que salga la shape de corazón, so we get the heart shape, squish it down a little bit. Let's see what happens here. A ver qué pasa. I actually never done this. Nunca había hecho esto de corazones. Pero si no le quieres hacer de corazones, la puedes hacer sin corazones, ¿verdad? Puedes hacerlo nomás, echarlo así nomás. You can put it right there if you want to. Without putting a shape of a heart or anything like that. In this case, I'm doing a little shape. En este caso, yo voy a hacer mi nuevo invento. Lo puse para abajo. Y... you have to cover it, but in this case I have these covers here already, so it's gonna moist everything. Lo tienes que tapar, lo puedes tapar si quieres, pero como yo tengo las tapaderas estas, pues no lo tengo que tapar. Pero en este caso, in this case, you don't have to cover because I already have those tops, like these covers here already. So about 4 to 5 minutes, como en 4 o 5 minutos, chequealos, que no te va a quemar, que estén doraditos. Check them that they don't burn. Make sure they got that nice goldish brown. Que tengan ese color como oro, color cafecito, doradito. Y se voltea y ya están. Espérate unos 3 to 4 minutes. De 3 a 5 minutos. Ok, now, ahora lo vamos a voltear. We're gonna flip it. Le vamos a quitar estas formas. Ya debe estar doradito. No fueron 3 minutos, fueron como. It was about 2 and a half to 3 minutes. So depending on your fire, depende en la lumbre, la tengo así de baja, so you guys can see how high it is. I had to lower it down, le tuve que bajar para que no se me quemaran, so they don't burn on me. So now we're gonna flip them. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna to figure this out because I, like I said, never done this before. Okay, now like I said, they're ready, they flip. So we're gonna take this off. Le vamos a quitar esta. Ya deben estar ready. They should be already nice and crispy. We're gonna flip it. Vamos a darle la vuelta. Ya están los hash browns de corazón. There's the hearts hash brown. Nice and crispy, doraditos. Ese color está perfecto. Dice un cocinero, no hay color, no hay sabor. Entonces aquí está, ya tiene color y tiene su sabor. Eso vamos a ver ahorita. Lo podemos poner, we can put a little bit of pimienta. Casi no tiene, there's no. Poquita sal, we can put a little bit of salt. Okay. Y ahí está. There it is. Señores, denle un like, suscríbanse por favor. Y acuérdense que este canal está lleno de sorpresas. No sabes lo que voy a subir para la otra semana. Los miro para la otra. Don't remember to subscribe and like. You never know what I'm gonna come up next. This channel is full of surprises. So, I don't just do one thing, I can be surprised you with anything can come up on this channel. So thanks very much, muchas gracias. Nos vemos para la próxima. See you guys next time.